Here's Cameron Medhurst, close friend of Kurt Browning's. They exchanged words just before their warm-up, gave each other a vote of confidence. He's the Australian champion, 26 years of age from Sydney, and like Gregor Filipovski, enjoying his third Olympic Games.
Well, he's been as high as 10th in the world. He's been up and down from 20th, back down to 10, up to 17. He's really hoping for a top 10 finish here. He touches down on the triple lutz, but completes it.
In his camel spin. And I think he's a fine example of an athlete who's dedicated to his sport. Anyone who has participated in three Olympiads certainly has a love and a desire to go out there and do what he obviously thinks is most important, that is to skate.
He's had a lot of problems with injuries these last couple of years. Here he's going into his triple flip. And he rolls out of that one, unfortunately. And he said he wasn't training pain-free until November.
Australia, who's felt over the years that his country of origin has sometimes cost him in the eyes of the judges who just don't expect good skating through Australia.
Well, here we're looking at a footwork sequence. As he comes off the ice. And here we're going to look at his combination. Triple lutz.
Let's go downstairs. Rob McLean's with Kurt Browning.
Right, Chris, thank you very much. Kurt, how could I possibly know what you're thinking? So why don't you tell me in Canada?
Without profanity? I don't know. boy, that happened fast. Like I said to CBS, I wouldn't have changed that jump for the world. And my coach says that my right arm was down. It's a bad habit of mine that I sometimes do without knowing it. What it does is it doesn't give you any check, and the rotation just pulls you off the edge. The ice was really hard tonight, and I just made a mistake.
I know you're crushed, but you fought back. You must be very proud of the way you caught yourself on the jump down at the far end to really gather this program. Did you feel your energies and your mind just leave you when that mistake occurred?
Actually, I thought of that in the next spin. I thought, I just missed my combination in the Olympic Games, and I can't believe I'm still thinking. But, you know, that's part of the training, and now that I'm off the ice, it hurts. It really hurts to have made that mistake, and that's part of competition. I didn't want it to happen here, but... now that it's happened, you know, we got the long program. We're just going to see what we can do.
Yeah, that's the thing. You now go into this program on Saturday, and you can let it fly. And I really felt with what you did, you've learned. Things have gone so well after an eighth-place finish in Calgary. You just took the world by storm. Maybe the missing the Canadians, there was so much on your mind. Can you analyze it that way?
Well, it would have been really nice to have a few competitions before this one, but that's just not the way it was. And, you know, I felt ready, you know. It's funny because you make one small mistake out there and then you try to atone for it for months and months of work, but it was just that. It was just one small mistake, and because it's the Olympic Games, it's everyone looks at it. So, you know, it's nothing more than that. Just made a mistake at the wrong time.
So many people feel so much for you and are with you all the same. And there's
the
Saturday to come.
Great. The Canadians out there were still behind me, and I appreciate that from them. It's been a long career, and it's nice that they applauded the way they did, even though we had a fall.
Cheers, Kurt. Thanks, and good luck.
Thank you.
Thanks, Ron. Boy, it is a tough sport. One loss of an edge can mean so much. And what it means is that Kurt will have to win the long program on Saturday, and Viktor Petrenko can finish no higher than third for him to realize his goal of winning Olympic gold.